Scientists have recently rediscovered a core sample obtained by a covert military operation in Greenland during the Cold War. At the bottom of the core sample, they discovered frozen soil which held plant fragments that appeared to have been flash frozen and turns the idea that Greenland has been covered in ice for the last 3 million years on its head. Let's find out more. In 1959, during the Cold War, the US Army Corps of Engineers began construction of Camp Century in northwestern Greenland. This was part of an operation called Project Iceworm. It is thought that it was a covert mission to build a subsurface base concealing hundreds of nuclear warheads, where they would be within striking distance of the Soviet Union. Oddly enough, they then proceeded to take various core samples from deep below the ice. One of the samples they took measured 3.4 meters in length and was taken from a depth of 1.3 kilometers below the ice surface. After the Army terminated Project Iceworm, the Corps went into storage, initially at the State University of New York and then later at the Niels Bohr Institute in Copenhagen. There it would lie waiting in a freezer until it was rediscovered in 2017. When the scientists started to look at the ice core, they discovered something rather remarkable. Hidden in the core sample were fragments of plants that were flowering plants, a type that should not exist in these harsh conditions. Currently, Greenland is covered in large ice sheets, and these are thought to have existed for at least 3 million years. These tiny fragments would suggest that Greenland must have been ice-free in the much more recent past. At the base of the ice core, they found frozen chunks of sediment, about 10 centimeters cubed. They initially put them in a glass jar and forgot about them. And it wasn't until 2017, during an inventory of the content of one of the freezers, that the curator recognized the long-lost core samples. When they rinsed the frozen soil to sort it into different size grains, they noticed little black things floating in the water. When the scientists put these particles under a microscope, they were in for quite a surprise. They could see small twigs and leaves in the frozen sediment. The only way they could describe what they were seeing was as if they were freeze-dried. When they pulled them out and put a little water on them, they would unfurl. They looked as though they had died yesterday. These plants could grow in Greenland only if the island's ice sheets were almost gone. The next step in their study was to try and work out exactly how recently this may have happened. In order to attempt to date these plants, they identified isotopes of aluminium and beryllium. It is thought that these isotopes can be used to determine age. These isotopes are thought to accumulate through the atmosphere via the exposure to radiation into the exposed minerals. Once they are buried, they would no longer receive these and therefore would slowly decay. They determined, based on the isotope ratios, that these plants could date to between a few hundred thousand years to a million years ago. Interestingly, traces of leaf wax in the core sediment seem to match those of the present-day tundra ecosystem, suggesting that these plants are not far removed from those we find nowadays. What is interesting in this article is that they focus mainly on the fact that it presents a big headache in terms of the ice sheet covering in Greenland, and seems to suggest that the idea that these have existed for 3 million years is wrong, and that there are at least two separate events in the last 1 million years where large parts of Greenland were ice-free. More shocking to me is the state of preservation of the samples themselves. The fact that they describe them as freeze-dried is of particular interest, but it's not something that they speculate on. They describe them as fossils only because I think they think they are so old. In fact, there is nothing fossilized about them. Something caused the leaves and twigs to be flash frozen, preserving them. The fact that they could rehydrate them and then they uncurl is absolutely stunning. Now, this idea of flash freezing is something that we've talked about as part of the Earth in Upheaval series. We find mammoth carcasses perfectly preserved in both Alaska and Siberia. These, by their dating, are from a very different event, but as we saw, they have discovered plants and seeds in Siberia, which seem to indicate that areas here too were not covered in ice and appeared to be a much more temperate climate with a large ecosystem supporting many different plants. So why would that not be the case for Greenland? Are these events in any way connected? If we look at their dating method, then it should be immediately obvious that there are a number of problems with dating with isotopes. Firstly, we really don't know the isotope ratios in the past. We can only extrapolate on what we know are the ratios today. We also know that the half-life of radioactive elements does not remain constant, but can be affected by external factors to speed it up. Thinking about it in terms of the SAM model may make this a little bit more obvious, as we just need to stimulate the instability to initiate ejection of an alpha particle or beta particle to cause the atom to seek a more stable state. If all these events are connected by a huge electrical storm, then this could indeed be a catalyst to change these rates. I find it odd that the question of how these plants became flash frozen was not even considered. This clearly shows that this wasn't a gradual change from one climate to another. Something very dramatic happened to flash freeze these plants and dehydrate them in an instant. What is also interesting is that these are all small fragments, requiring a microscope to see the detail. No large fragments were present. Now, they obviously only have one ice core to look at, so that might just be coincidence. There is also soil surrounding the plant material suggesting some sort of ecosystem. But it reminds me of the chaotic remains found in Alaska and the broken trees in Siberia. So I suppose one possibility that they seem not to have considered was that these samples did not originate here, but were transported there. But we still need to consider that they were found 1.3 kilometers below the ice surface. One other glaring question is what exactly were the army doing here back in the 1960s? It is thought that Project Iceworm was a top secret program with the aim of building a network of mobile nuclear launch sites under the Greenland ice sheet. This part of the mission was kept secret from the government of Denmark. Instead, a highly publicized cover project known as Camp Century was launched in 1960. Its mission was to test the feasibility of construction techniques under ice. Its grand plan was to have a system of tunnels of over 4,000 kilometers in length. Within 3 years, ice core samples taken by geologists working at Camp Century demonstrated that the glacier was moving much faster than anticipated and would destroy the tunnels and planned launch stations in about 2 years. In 1965, the site was evacuated, and finally in 1966, the camp was closed down completely. Is this why they were drilling here, to uncover what might have happened in our recent past? This article asks many more questions than it answers, but I see some clear connections to some of the other things that I've looked at. As always, be brave, be curious, the truth is waiting for us. Until next time.